First Cassette. This talk titled The Dhamma Way was given by Venerable Prajnanendra Amaro Bhikkhu on the 5th of May 1992 at Borough Memorial Hall, Borough Town, New South Wales, Australia.
This evening and just briefly explain to you the program for the night. Prayachan is a well-respected meditation teacher, master, from Thailand, from the Theravadan Buddhist tradition. We're also lucky enough to have him as the abbot of the Sanyutaram Buddhist Monastery in Bundanoon. Some people I've spoken to are a little bit confused about the Dalai Lama and Prajnanendra. I think my chiropractor told me the Dalai Lama was coming to Barrow on Wednesday night. They're both Buddhists. The Dalai Lama comes from the Tibetan Buddhist tradition and is the leader of the Tibetan people and the Tibetan Buddhist tradition. Prajnanendra is from the Theravadan Buddhist tradition, which is the tradition in Thailand and many other Asian countries. But they both speak about Buddhism and the easing of suffering through the teaching of the Buddha. So they're both brothers in Buddhism, and they're both speaking in Canberra this Wednesday at 5 o'clock at the Buddhist Centre in Lynham, and they'll be speaking together. The program for this evening, from 7.15 to 8.30, Prayachan will give a meditation session and a Dharma talk or talk on Buddhism. And from 8.30 to 9.15, there'll be time for you to ask questions. And from 8 o'clock, there's supper time and people are free to talk with any of the monks or Prayachan during that time. There are also books at the back of the hall if you want to look at them or take some. I'm aware that the program might be longer than some of you are able to stay for, so you're more than welcome to leave the hall before the finish of the proceedings if you need to, if you're doing that during the meditation session, if you just do it quietly. So thank you for coming this evening, and I'll hand you over to Prajnanendra.
Dear Baba and Siddha, I'm very happy to see you all here. How we can overcome that condition? How we can free your mind from that condition? How we can free your mind from attachment? It's not so easy. But it's not too difficult also if we try to be aware. Try to acknowledge every moment and in that moment we can see when our mind is calm, our thought, our speed, our action will be alright. We'll have right thought, right action, right speed. We can do anything very well. It means in that moment we been happy set by itself automatically very well. We don't harm others when our mind is good. When we are wholesome in our mind, when we think of every life, when we look out to others and try to contemplate on this life and on every life is our free life. And we observe and try to contemplate. Every life is our friend, or as friend who share suffering, who share birth, on a sickness and death. And we all, or they all, want to free from all suffering. day on want to find peace and real happiness, how we can have loving kindness, how we can help other more, how we can have pity and our loving kindness will grow up. When that feeling absorbs to our mind, when we see every life is our friend or a friend who shares suffering, we cannot harm other animals.
And why the first precept the Buddha suggests abstain from killing living things? And second precept the Buddha suggests we should abstain from stealing. And thus, precept abstain from committing adultery. And fourth precept, abstain from telling lies or talk in bad way to others. We should not keep bad talk to other, okay, give bad word to other. And the last precept for general precept, we call it five precept. For human beings, we should observe five precept. And the last precept, the Buddha suggests, you should abstain from intoxicant or indulging, no drink, because if we drink whiskey or wine, it can make us drunk, it can make drunk or drunkenness. And no smoke also, we should stop it. Anything from intoxicant or includes temptations. We can see when we stay with family, if we are the leader of family, got drunk, our member in our family are not happy. They do not grab with our drunkenness. And if we have loving kindness to our family, and we should do ourselves be good sampan, we should make ourselves good example for our family also. When we have kid, our kid will be upset if mother or father got drunk. Parent should be example for their kid. If we still drunk, we suggest them to stop drink. Maybe they cannot listen. They cannot listen. They don't want to listen because we cannot do by ourselves. Why Buddhist teaching? The most important thing, we choose train and develop ourselves well first. If we can train and develop ourselves in the right way, I can say that in nowadays most of people in this world still have suffering, still have a lot of problems because they don't train themselves. Because we don't train ourselves. If we train and try to develop ourselves, or blame ourselves, remind ourselves, and try to do good more and more, this is truth. Nobody never done something wrong. We all have ever done something wrong before, little bit or much, we all have it. But we can improve, and we should improve and try to develop One who accepts we are wrong something and try to train and develop self, that person will be peaceful and happy more, and the wise man will place that person is very good person. And if people in this world try to look turn in themselves and try to train and try to remind and try to contemplate what is the best thing we should do in our life, and we should start in present, even the past is wrong, it passed already, and the future is not come yet. We should start in present. We should not don't worry too much for the future, for the Buddhist teaching. For Buddhist teaching, we believe the law of cause and effect. We believe the law of karma. If we have good cause, we have good effect, we have good result. If we have good karma, we have good life. Anything will be better and will be good more and more. I think our life we own, our life come, our life control our life. Our life is depend on our self, depend on our conduction, our operation, depend on our action, our speed, our thought. If we have right thought, we have right understanding, right thought, right speed, right action, right livelihood, right effort, right mindfulness, right concentrations, and try to develop it more, we call this way is Eightfold Noble Path. If we try to develop and follow this way more and more, we can find peace and happiness more, and we can help others more exactly. Our life is not depend on the star or the moon. Somebody, when they have problem, when they have suffering, they go for us. The person when you know about fortune teller. In Asian country or even the West also, they still believe and they cling a lot. But for Buddhist teaching, we don't concern about a thing. For Buddhist teaching, we try to find out, the cause of that problem. What is the cause of problem? And we know the cause clearly and try to improve and try to develop in the right way more and more. And I think if we all try to train and develop ourselves, we still have duty, we still have our responsibility to take care of family, to concern with anything around us, and try to have loving kindness more and more. In that moment, when we have loving kindness, our heart will burn and we will be peaceful and happy. And if we try to help others with pure loving kindness, we can get love and sincerity from that person, from others. Even we don't want to take back, but from our good karma, it will come back to our life in the good thing. The good thing will come back to our life. Like you grow the flower, you love flower, you try to look after the flower, it give flower to you. It's been boom, it's grown up when you plant or you grow it. If you don't look after it, maybe it not grow up good, or it not grow up completely. We can see in present moment when our heart is good, when we have loving kindness in that moment, wholesomeness grow up in our heart. If we try to correct more and more, try to correct our loving kindness, try to correct our giving, we should know how to give, how to help others. With self-sacrifice, we don't want to take anything back. When we receive from our loving kindness, from our giving, they will be impressed. That it's been keep last long in their heart also. And at that moment, our virtues of loving kindness will go up more and more, more and more. We will have happiness from giving more than taking back. From taking. Happiness, the happiness from giving much more than taking back. Much more than happiness from taking. In Buddhist teaching, of all the Dhamma, the Buddha suggests we should try to help others, and I think it is the most important things. The most important thing for human being, we should have giving each other. We should have help others. If we all have this thing in our mind, in our heart, I think it is high duty, and it is highest duty of human being. Helping, try to help others with pure loving kindness, and we should often contemplate everything in our life or anything around us in this world is impermanent. This law is absolute law of nature, and it is very true. It's never except anybody, even the kings. Everything is impermanent, and everything is unstable, and everything is non-self. It's just a loop, rise and gone, rise and gone. The Buddha said that it is just only natural on, like this, just pass and pass. For example, our body, now, we sit and feel comfortable. If you sit so long, it changes again. Maybe you feel pain, or you feel numb on your leg, on your knee, or on your back, or some parts of your body. It's subject to change. Even we don't want to get pain, but you must pain finally. Even we change our posture again, it happens again. You open. And you must close again and open again. Cannot stay too long. Everything is subject to change, and it is impermanent. And our body also is getting old every moment. In fact, we cannot hold it. We cannot stop it. Old age, sickness and death. We should know it, and we still look after, we still cure, we still try to help our body for good health. But finally, it doesn't believe us. Because in fact, it is belong to nature. We just only stay and use it just for temporarily. Finally, it's not all, and maybe somebody getting old already. And we must accept it. And finally, we must leave from this body. We must leave from everything or anything in this world. Why did Buddha say that? One who has carefulness, one who has carefulness, that person will try to do good more and try to find the peaceful way and try to do anything in our best before we leave from this body. We still look after it, we still have duty to take care of our body and our mind also, don't forget. We take care of our mind, look after our mind, not only body. We should look after both things, body and mind. Somebody forget to look after their mind. They are worried too much about body, but they never look after their mind. Even we try to look after, try to take care very well, but finally it doesn't believe. It doesn't believe us even we have intention to control it. Belong to nature, and it is absolute law of nature. It never accept everybody or anyone. Finally, we must be old, we must be sick, and we must pass away, or we must leave from this body. When that day come, the death will come to this life. But one who have Dhamma, or one who have ultimate release, is mean one who realize and free their mind from attachment completely. They accept it is sadness, it belong to nature. Just only one kind of human being, just only one kind of human being, we call them the Arahanta. They are highest noble one. We call them that Arahan, Arahan. Have you heard this word? Arahan is mean that person must got enlightenment. The Buddha is the first one, and on Arahanta who is his disciple, who realized the same the Buddha realized, and they on got enlightenment. That person or those persons free from all suffering. They free from birth, old age, sickness, and death. And they free from wounded condition. Can you understand? They free from possessive and negative condition. No more suffering after they got enlightenment. They become freedom completely inside. They become, we can call them that, they become eternal life or immortal. Any kind of suffering cannot buy him anymore. Cannot block, cannot make them unhappy. Because they're free from attachment. But they take time to practice so long and try to contemplate.
We all can learn how to free from all suffering. For Buddhist teaching, our purpose, our point, how we can have a good life and how we can free from all suffering, how we can find peace and happiness before we leave from this world. We don't want to wait until we die. No need. We want to find peace and real happiness in this life or in present life. We still work. Anything, if we like to take, the Buddha said that we can take, we can get. But we should not harm others, or we can take without harming others. And we can take in the right way. We still work, we still get, we still eat, we still sleep, we still walk, we still stand, we still sit. We still do anything normally. The same general people. But we should observe precept or try to stop harming others. Why the first of Buddhist teaching not to do on evil. And we can see when we were born the first day or when we still baby, we all have precept well. Even our mother have pregnant us, he is still in, what do you say? In the womb, when we still in the womb. Even we come out, when first we come out, we are baby, we were baby. We have five precept well also. Even now, you are sitting now, you all have five precepts completely already. But when you come out, I cannot guarantee. When you come out or you go back home, I cannot guarantee. You will know by yourself. We can call it that. This way is natural way, is original way. We have it before. Any time, any moment when we have good heart, when we have a wholesomeness in our heart, when we have loving kindness, we cannot break any precept. We cannot do something wrong, we cannot do bad action, we cannot talk in bad way. When we have wholesome in our heart, this means our original of our lives is have this thing completely, automatically by itself. It has these things, it has dhamma by itself automatically. But when we have greed, hatred, delusions, we lost these things again. Why we should control and strive to have intention to observe precepts. Just only five precepts and we have family, we should have it first. And if we can learn how to live with content life, try to have simple life, try to review luxury things,
Some person have a lot of dress, a lot of clothes, so many set, food in the room. And some person have a lot of cosmetic for makeup, their face, or they try to decorate to their body, to their face, a lot. They correct so many things about that. And they are worried about that thing. If one would like to practice more, we should know how to reduce and should know how to let go. If we can let it go, try to have only simple, not too much. We can have it, we can use it, but should not too much. And even our clothes, for months, you see, I have and we all have only one set. Really? And when I came here special, I use this one more, but yeah, flexible because it's cold. We use it, but we use it for just only necessary thing. It's the basics of human being. We should have only necessary thing. It is the way of one would like to practice. Can you understand what I mean, sir? Try to live with simple. Try to have simple life. Try to have content life. Even we can got many things a lot, we have ability to get a lot of clothes, to get a lot of money, but we can give away. We can give others. We can help others. We can get wholesomeness and amour it more and more. For ourselves, we use it, not too much. And it is my slogan when I talk with Buddhist people or I talk to monks or to layman people also. When we like to practice, try to have we should observe and contain life and cut the temptation out absolutely. Do you know temptation?
Cut it out.
No gremlins, even lotto, no. You don't want to get it. Somebody is weak and they like to play card. They have appointment with friend. We like to enjoy together with play card. Card. What do you say? Card. In Thailand, they have a lot also. And sometimes they lose a lot of money and they lose energy in their heart. And they addicted. Every weekend they must go to that place, they must go to casino. Any kind of gambling is not good for us. We should cut it out. We should not touch it. We just know a little bit and should stay away. We should not stay close thing with that thing, with those things. And observe 5 pieces and try to have loving kindness. And try to, if it is possible, we should have our routine every day, morning and evening, to meditate and think of loving kindness, of the Buddha, of God, of measure, of pure nature. Absorb pure energy from nature, from the Buddha or from God. Same, I think so. Anyway, if it can make our heart be fresh, it can make our life be bloom, be happy and peaceful, we will do in that way. How we can do it? When we absorb that feeling and think of great compassionate love, for example, think of great compassionate love or the Buddha and absorb
like a Buddha, keep rising directly to our heart, to our life. Like a holy, like a holy blessing, or like a holy currents from nature, of nature, pass our body and pass directly or absorb directly to our heart, and our face will be smile in that moment. We can create that thing. We can create our energy by ourselves when we think of good things. Maybe 10 or 15 minutes before we go to bed and after we wake up every day, morning, twice times a day, minimum 15 minutes. If you can do each time 15 minutes minimum, if you have chance, you have time, you choose, you can sit longer with meditation. We sit in comfort posture, maybe half lotus or any posture if you feel comfortable, and straight up our sitting posture and think of the good thing, think of pure nature. Maybe you can focus in your heart, you can imagine about bloom some lotus or bloom some of any kind of flower, and take a deep breath and soothe it and absorb that feeling. Any object, you can focus it and contemplate on that thing and absorb that feeling to our heart and radiate our loving kindness to others. We can radiate and can expand that feeling around us, around our body and surround us, and pass to nature, every molecule, every atmosphere, every atmosphere and everywhere on direction unlimited, and every sphere, may they all be well and happy, all human beings. And all beings, may they all be well and happy, free from enmities, whatever merit we have done, these merit, may they be shared by all. And we absorb the good thing in our heart, in our breathing in, when we breathe in. We can take a deep breath and breathe in deeply, softly, and absorb the feeling, the good thing come, good energy, pure energy, spacious energy, come to our life, come to our body, and expand around. You can feel around, and when breathe out, take the bad thing out, any kind of the bad thing, any kind of disease out. We can create it, and it is the good way, spacious way for loving kindness meditation, and this can help our body be well. You will have good health and long life, and in that moment your heart and brain function will work together, balanced and very good also. Tension and straight out. Because most of the time, particularly in nowadays, most of people in big city have a lot of tension and have a lot of straight. They have a lot of worriness. Even they have money, you have even people in nowadays, some family, some group or some person have a lot of material. Even they are very rich people, but they are still suffering. They still have problem in their heart. They still have problem in here.
They still nervous. They still have tension, have a lot of tension and have a lot of stress. Material cannot help them to free from all suffering, never. Just only help them to be convenient, to be comfortable for body, for physical, but for heart cannot help them to find peace and happiness. When something change, they cannot control, but their mind be calm. And they will cling a lot of things. When something subject to change, when they cling, they will be upset and they will be suffering again. When they keep some person they love, when those person leave, or left, they will be very sad. Or something changed. They cannot control their mind to free from attachment, to free from all suffering. Why for the Buddhist teaching, we still work, we still have duty to take care, to concern, to synchronize with everything very well. But with our attachment, with our suffering. But we must have understand that thing, those things. We must have wisdom. We must have realizations before something happens. Wisdom can go up because we must contemplate. And we should often contemplate until we see truly, until we see the truth condition of that thing clearly, completely. Until we know now our mind free from attachment. But we have inspirations. We have encouragement to continue to do good, to continue to confront any kind of problem, any kind of phenomena with our worriness, with our suffering, because we have energy, Dhamma energy. We call this thing is Dhamma. Dhamma is in keep our mind be bright and light. This can help our heart, our mind, our life be bright and light from little by little. Like one who like to exercise, like to have good health, must exercise every day, not only one day or a few days and stop too long. You just exercise every day. And we can correct energy, our body function will be balanced and will be stronger more and more, more and more. Like we meditate or we practice our heart, we practice our mind also. We choose train every day and we should be mindful every moment. This thing is very important for Buddhist teaching. And I can say that for meditation, the mindfulness and awareness is the most important thing. If we have bright mindfulness and awareness well, completely, no more suffering. Anything cannot block and cannot make problem in our heart. Usually we have, but it's not complete. Sometimes we have, we lose it. We have, but it's not complete. In Buddhism, just only one kind of human being who have complete, who have bright and complete mindfulness permanently is Aranta. Just only Aranta, one kind of human being. Usually for ordinary people, for ignorant people, have not completely. They have just only temporarily.
When we got greed, hatred, delusion, we lose right mindfulness again. And you can see at any moment when we free from greed, hatred, or when we free from greed, hatred, delusion, in that moment, our mind will be very good. Our mind will be clear. Our mind is clear and is calmness. Our mind is calm and peaceful also. And we can see everything or anything when we want to contemplate. We will see truly, we will see deeply. Like a candlelight, when it have concentrate in candlelight, is that vibrate. It will be stronger than the vibrate wand and can have energy more than the vibrate wand, clearer, stronger, more powerful, and it can keep candle bar last long, longer than the vibrates one. When it's vibrate, the candlelight is vibrate. It's destroy or it's melt candle wax, candle bar quicker, more quick. The same when we have good heart, it can keep healthy a long life and good brain also. Why? Meditation is very important for all of us, not only for monk, not only for Buddhist people, not only for some group, everybody or everyone. It is very useful for human being, and I think it is necessary for us to learn in this thing, because usually most of time we lost it. We have not good concentration enough. And the calmness is the most happiness. When we have calmness, we will work very well, we will do everything very well. Because inside is clear, we will have energy more. And for all of us, we choose start to learn. Sorry, how many number all of you who have ever learned meditation before, please show me your hand. Five many also, thank you very much. You learn by yourself or some master teach you? Both, from the book and from some master. This thing is very useful and it is very important for us. And other things, when we die that day, when the day comes, one who have not meditation well, one who never learn meditate, they will be very confused in their heart. Because they never released. They never know how to let go. They will got frightened and are afraid to death. They cannot accept because always clings. They always cling themselves too much. So much. when the days come, one will never contemplate. One will never learn how to let go. Never learn meditation. Never contemplate. On a sickness and death, when that thing come or that phenomena come to our life, we cannot free our mind from our suffering. We cannot free our mind from attachment. Even we still have suffering, even we still have worriedness, even we still have problem, we have less suffering, we have less suffering, we have less worriedness. If we do before, if we try to practice before, and practice is very important. Even we know, we understand it, but we never try to practice, never try to train our mind, never contemplate how we can overcome it. We cannot. When something happens, we will be suffering, we still suffering. Why? Practice is very important. And now, 8:17, the time it passed very quick. Time and light is grow on very quick, flow on very quick. It's never turn back. It's never come back. When we got on already. Even we like to be young again, cannot. We must accept it. For body function and everything must like that. It is absolute law of nature. Why the Buddha said that we should often contemplate and try to see it truly and try to accept it until we accept it well, until we can free your mind from attachment. Even something happen, we still be calm and peaceful. One who practice well will know by self. Nobody guarantee us. We will guarantee by self, by ourselves. We should often test our mind also, like an examination. Sometimes you meditate very well in morning. When you go to work, maybe you saw some person do something not so nice. If you got angry, it means you cannot pass your examination. If you still alright, inside still calm, still peaceful, it means you have good meditation. And we should learn every kind of phenomena. Phenomena is normal. And we should not stay away any kind of phenomena, any kind of events. The Buddha said that, and the wise man said that, if without obstacle, a merit cannot born. If without obstacle, a merit is not ripe. we should confront any kind of obstacle. It should not stay away. It can make our heart stronger if we have mindfulness and wisdom. And we should learn how to overcome. We should think it is normal. It's happened not only ourselves, not only you alone. Everybody must have obstacle. Every life, everybody must have problem. Maybe more than us. Why we are complaining? Why we stay away? We should learn it. We should think it is the lesson for learning in our life. Like the tree, it grow up every season. Even now, start a little bit cold. The tree and flower never complain. Even the winter come, and even grow up in spring again. It accept and grow up. Every season, if it snow, it cannot keep the leaf. It cannot keep its leaf. It's been leaf. It leaf.
Recorded by Sunyata Studio. If you interested in this cassette, please contact Dhamma Information Fund, Bangkok, Thailand. Telephone 02-538-0967. Thank you.